Koko Beware.
Koko Beware was a, excuse me, was a little guy who was a heck of a worker. And it always a happy-go-lucky guy. He was, he up until today, he is the guy that I try to help the most, that I send guys that, that are doing shows. Or I think I just got him a gig. I don't know if he's been there yet, to go to the UK somewhere. And he called me and thanked me. I always try to, you know, get him some stuff. And he's always very grateful. You know, he lost his bird. His house went totally burnt down, and his bird was inside. He couldn't save the bird. And he says, Tito, he says, the saddest thing was, you know, hearing Frankie crying like a baby, you know, like a real human being, you know, and it was really hard for him.
One thing, since I've been doing these series of interviews, is that whenever I mention Koko Beware, it always... He's just such a badass. I mean, there was Jim Troy, there was Paul Roma, there was Steve Kern. It just, everyone seems to start a fight with him, and he always ends it.
He always ended it until he faced Jim Duggan. I heard Jim Duggan slapped him in the face, you know, pretty hard. And, you know, I don't think there was a follow through with Jim Duggan, but. I was never around with any of those fights, but I heard about Paul Roma, and I heard about the other ones that you mentioned, but just hearsay.
Yeah, you always miss
but,
them.
But, you know, I know that when I wrestled him, you know, and the way he moved around, I said to myself, if I was in a real fight with this guy, it'd be pretty hard for me to land a good punch on him.